Hi, welcome back to CADable. This is engr. Ibrahim Omer, and today I'll be showing you how to convert a 2D sketch into 3D objects in AutoCAD. I'm using AutoCAD 2018, and if you're using a blue version or a future version, you can still follow this tutorial, right? So let's go to here, start drawing, and here I am in drafting and annotation mode. So let's make four sketches. Let's make a circle. Let's go to circle center, center radius, and let's make an arbitrary circle, and let's make an ellipse, and let's draw an ellipse here. Okay, and let's just drag this point to here and this point to here. Okay, and let's make a rectangle, let's say here to here. Okay, and let's make an arbitrary shape using a polyline, and let's make a here to here, and here to here. Let's make another line. Let's locate this line and end this line here. Okay, that's fine. We have four sketches. Let's drag this circle from here to here. Okay, now I will change this to 3D modeling, and now you will see the commands, different 3D commands. So let's go to here, extrude, and here you can see that I am in top plane, and let's go to extrude. Before going to extrude, let's change this to isometric, and I can change this to here isometric, and I can change this from here as well. So I think this is the easiest option which I like. Let's click this, and here you can see the 3D. Let's go to here extrude, and here you can see some extrude, some 3D command like loft, revolve, sweep, and you can all find these commands in SolidWorks as well with same names. So let's click here extrude, and let's click this 2D sketch, and press enter, and let's make an extrusion of this. Also press enter command again to repeat the extrusion command, and let's make this extrusion. Click enter again, and this time I will make a negative extrusion in the negative Z direction, and let's make an extrusion this one. Press enter again, and this time I will make an extrusion here. One very important thing is you need a closed sketch, and you can see that all lines of this arbitrary shape are making a closed loop, right? If you have not a closed loop, so you cannot make a extrusion. It's a very basic and a very important thing. So let's press enter key again, and let's select this one, enter key again, and let's make an extrusion here. Now you'll see that these objects are not looking real, because we are using this 2D wireframe, and when we will change it to let's say some realistic or shaded, so it will be a real 3D object, right? So let's click here, and here you can see all the let's say conceptual, hidden, realistic, shaded, right? And I can also find this option from here, so you can either go to here or go to here. So let's make it conceptual, and now you will see the all the 3D objects. You can see that you can turn off grids if you want. Let's turn off these grids, and also let's go to here, and let's change it from here, let's say realistic, and now you'll see the different shadow. Let's go to, let's say, shaded, and let's go to here sketchy, and let's make it let's say conceptual again. So it's very easy, and AutoCAD is very limited to 3D. So that's it for today's tutorial. I hope you like it, and if you have any questions regarding this tutorial or any other tutorial in my list, you can ask in comment section. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to our channel for more informative and interesting videos. Thank you.